He is one of the new members of the PGA Tour. Brad Fritsch got his PGA card after finishing 18th in the web.com tour earnings list. He qualifies just shy of his 35th birthday, and Brad joins us now. Well, first of all, congratulations.
Thanks so much. Thank you for having me as well.
It's a long, it's been a long journey for you, and I was a member at Bondhead in the mid 2000s or 2005, 6 or whatever. And some of the people there got together and gave you some money to help you in your journey. And so I started to watch with great interest how you were progressing and sometimes not progressing. Surely there were times, Brad, where you were ready to forget it or not?
I don't think so, just because I never had a plan B to do anything else.
No, I see.
It was basically for a lack of, I don't want to say interest in other things, but, you know, to start a career all over after doing golf, it would have taken a lot of different things had to go on. So that was one thing. The other thing is that if you look at my career, it's just I've always improved year over year, with the exception of maybe 2009 when I lost my status on what was called the Nationwide Tour, now the Web.com Tour. And I had a few things go on in my life that year. Built a house, had a baby, so that was kind of a weird time of year, or a time of my life anyway, different. And but if you just kind of look at my stats, how I've played, I've always improved year after year. So I've never set the world on fire, so to speak, never won any big events or dominated, you know, a tour or anything like that, but I feel like I've been solid over the course of my career, just at a lower level. So this year was definitely kind of the outlier. I improved a lot. And obviously, over the course of the year, proved that I could be real consistent. And so, number 18 on the money list, I'm quite proud of that, especially without a win, because a lot of guys who won this year actually didn't get their tour card.
That's interesting, isn't it? That's usually not the way it works.
Right. So I'm pretty proud of the fact that, you know, I'd like to win, but considering I didn't win and still got in the top 25, I kind of like that, actually.
You know, Brad, I read a couple great quotes from your father in the Ottawa Sun. Not only did you always say, I have no plan B, but I guess your dad, after a while, even stopped asking you the question, what would happen if golf didn't work out, because you just refused to give him an answer.
Yeah, I think because, you know, my father knows a lot about golf, but I think to understand what it takes out on tour, I think you just have to play out there. And so only the player can understand either how close or how far away he is from making it. And so that was kind of, I think that might have been the reason for his stopping to ask me that question, because I think eventually he understood, well, it's not as simple as, well, you're a really good player, you should shoot 68 every round. It's not as simple as that. You know, tournament golf is so much different from, you know, regular rounds of golf at your local golf course. So that was, I think, the reason. And I'm glad he stopped asking me, because after a while it got kind of annoying.
What kind of fraternity is there among the Canadians? I mean, now you're going to go to the PGA Tour. Graham DeLatte's out there. You played with Graham on the Nationwide Tour, didn't you?
I played a little bit with Graham on the Canadian Tour. We kind of, when I was on the Nationwide Tour, he wasn't, and then he stepped actually from the Canadian Tour straight to the PGA Tour. So we've played in a few events together, and we've actually played a few rounds together in a Nationwide event one time at the Wayne Gretzky Tournament. But other than that, I don't know Graham really well. I know David Hearn a lot better, because
okay,
we kind of came up through the same, he's about my age as well. So, but it'll be fun. I think anytime you get more Canadians out on the PGA Tour, it's an important thing, because there just aren't that many of us.
And do you gravitate towards the other Canadian guys? Do you think, I mean, I know you haven't been there yet, but do you suspect that will happen?
I'm not real sure about that, because I've got a lot of friends just that I've made over the years from both the Canadian Tour, who are American, or other, you know, Australians or whatever.
Right.
And so, you know, golf is kind of a cliquey type of deal, and it just happens like that. And I think, you know, I'd like to spend time with those guys, because obviously they know more about playing out there than I do, and they've been really successful, especially this year. So even though Graham might be, you know, 6 or 7 years younger than me, I'm sure he can teach me a lot, actually.
Brad, describe that moment. What's it like when the round ends on Sunday, you know what the situation is, and all of a sudden it hits you. After all of this trying and after everything I've been through, I'm on the PGA Tour next year.
Well, last week was kind of a weird week because I pretty much knew I was guaranteed to get a tour card. A lot of different weird stuff had to go on, like certain players playing really well to pass me in the 25. But after I, you know, hit my shot on the green and two-putted, it was just kind of this big wave of relief. I wasn't sure exactly where my finishing position was going to be on the money list, but I knew I think I tied for ninth that week, so I was pretty sure I was going to move up, and that was a big deal. So I think I may have hurt the PGA Tour media guy's hand a little bit when I high-fived him coming off the green. But it was a great feeling, and I'm not going to lie. When I got into my car, put the clubs away, I got in my car and called my wife. She could barely answer the phone, and I could barely talk to her on the phone when I finally got her on the phone. So it was a pretty big deal.
How many events will you be able to play next year?
Always a good question. It basically depends how I start the year, whether I make some money on
right.
the West Coast. But I think there was some tweets going around today from Chris Stevenson of the Ottawa Sun, and, mm-hmm. and he figured out that the guy in my position from 2011, so number 18, I think he played 24 or 25 events this year.
Well, that's plenty, huh?
Pretty good.